A blessed morning, one and all. This is your Reverend Apostle Elijah Peter Chambers. I should have shared this vision and this prophetic word that the Lord has given me for the country of America and for the president of America. The Lord dragged me in a vision and showed me what is getting ready to take place in America. And I would like to use a scripture text from Daniel chapter 7 just to conclude what the Lord is revealing to me, and from a world leader perspective, and what may take place and who will come in, who will go. In Daniel chapter 7, it says, the first year of Belshazzar king, the Babylon, Daniel had a dream and a vision of his head upon the bed. And when he wrote the dream and told the sum of the matters, Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, four winds of the heavens strove upon the great sea. And four great beasts came up from the sea, diverse from another. And that has to do, when you see sea, it is symbolic to people. So a beast is going to rise from the people, four beasts. And the four great beasts came up out from the sea, diverse one from another, which means that they were different from each other. Beasts, the leaders that will rise up, four of them, they will come with different natures and characteristics. And the first was like a lion and had eagle's wing. I beheld the wings, therefore, were plucked up, and it lifted up the four and made stand upon the feet as a man, and a man's heart was given to it. In the vision, the Lord, I think it was last Friday, I can't remember, it was last Friday, the Lord dragged me into a vision and showed me the country of America. After, since the homosexual legislation in the White House, in the 52 states, homosexuality is legal, the Lord said, speak, my son, to the nations, the nation of America. And the Lord gave me seven revelations. One of them, that will happen to America. America will lose its world power and given to another. The great city will be destroyed. The second revelation, the Lord spoke to me, said America will experience catastrophes the world has never seen or ever experienced. Hallelujah. We saw in Buffalo, Georgia, and places where the snow killed so many people. Listen, America is on the verge for great trouble. People are going to run away from this territory, from this region. They're going to understand that the judgment has come upon the land, as Sodom and Gomorrah. The third revelation, Lord says, the president of America will become sick in his body. You have turned away from the statutes and commandments. The people will run away from America. Many will die in this land. Thousands, hundreds of people. What is getting ready to happen in America? It is going to affect even Jamaica. The fourth, this is the death. There is a death angel hanging over America. I saw an angel, an evil force in the atmosphere hanging over Jamaica. And not only from a pandemic perspective, a virus. People are going to die in this land as never before, because no one stood to speak against the evil that has been implemented in the country of America. America was a Christian country once, and they have turned, they have diverted. They will lose their power. They will lose their world power very soon. The fifth revelation, the Lord says, in a vision, I saw a nuclear bomb came from another country and dropped into one of the states. You are in trouble with God. America is in trouble. There is a bombing that is going to take place, a nuclear bomb that is going to fall into one of the states, and it's going to affect the global world. The sixth revelation, there is a plague that will hit America. Yes, America was hit with the corona. There's a plague that will hit America, and even Jamaica will be hit by this dangerous plague. 2023 will be a dreadful year for many. America, judgment is knocking at your door. The 52 states of America, there is going to be such a catastrophe, such a destruction that is going to affect the global world. And God is going to take away the world power from America and given to another. The world power will be given to another, thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah. The seventh revelation, God says he will remove the president of America after he has fulfilled his evil. There are many enemies in the White House. There will be war among them. Let God arise. Let the enemies be scattered. And even for Jamaica, Jamaica will be affected by this legislation. And I saw in a vision, the Lord gave me an open vision, and I saw men in black suit flew down from America in a white jet, coming to the leader of this land pertaining to the homosexual legislation. And Miss Hypocrite opposed me. But listen, what is yet to come to Jamaica, dog eat no supper. If you notice, over 2 to 3 years, most of our leaders, our clergymen, our pastors, our bishop, they have been silent. God has silenced them. As a matter of fact, COVID has silenced them. So I don't know where did Miss Hypocrite came from, because corona paralyzed you. And the cobra venom in your body shut you down. Are you coming to oppose the man of God and prophecies? Listen, most of the great prophets, they prophesied of things to come. They have died, and until today, some of these prophecies have not came to pass. So you know nothing about prophecies, my friend. You think you know, you're just religious and evil and political, and backing an organization that opposes the will and the will and purpose and destiny of God. In the land of Jamaica, as I spoke, the Lord reveals to me that our pastors, our clergymen, our bishops, they are connected to the criminal world. Many of them are connected to the criminal world through the political channel. And that is the reason, the root cause, so many of them are dying out. And this will be proven, thus saith the Lord. The Bible said that you cannot pour new wine into dirty bottle. You cannot mix with the evil. And some of you said that the state and the church should not mix. I'm not saying that the state and the church cannot come together, but the church must place a demarcation line, though they connect with politics or the government, that they should be the entity that speak righteousness. The Bible says that the church is the pillar and ground of truth. The church is the pillar and ground of truth, where truth is being exhibited, where truth is being exposed. Any church that you're attending and truth cannot be spoken, you're a part of an organization which is of Lucifer. The church, hallelujah, the Bible said, upon this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The church has lost its power in the land of Jamaica. And we've seen it. The church is on the back burner since this government came into power. They don't want to hear anybody that speak, thus said the Lord. And they pulled in the hungry belly pastors and bishops who are for their belly, and using it as a facade to carry out their diabolical evil. Come repeat to God. But the judgment that is coming to America, the Lord says it's going to affect Jamaica. Jamaica, America, you're at the verge of a mighty destruction. 2023 will be the year where there will be dreadful catastrophes, dreadful, hallelujah, murders, dreadful death, hallelujah, to the point that the heart of men will come into the mouth. Hallelujah. To repeat to God, the Bible declares, if it is possible, even the very elect will be deceived. The scripture in, I think it's 1 Corinthians, Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, it says that God has placed a delusion for them to believe a lie. And that is what is happening to our pastors.